First, to keep track of its position in the world. That's correct. All of our entities and grids need to know what position in the world they're at for a number of reasons, like physics, collision, and rendering. What about this? To know when it's time to die? This is actually not required. Not all entities have a concept of time, nor have a concept of death. For instance, landmine entities only live on the map for about 30 seconds. As such, they need to know how long they're staying around in life before they explode. Other entities, like the spawners, which will actually generate energy canisters and health canisters, never die, so they have no concept of life or death. They stick around until the map is unloaded. What about this one? To think or be able to do something each tick. This one is definitely a requirement. The definition of an entity, as we've discussed before, is that you have a class which contains some unique logic that makes this entity different from all the other ones in the world. The ability to think or have custom processing associated with an entity is critical to its definition. How about knowing what sounds to play? This is a little vague. Some entities will need the ability to know and play sounds during events. For instance, when a rocket hits the wall, we would hope that it plays its explosion sound. The player, for instance, may not need to know any sounds because the environment is making sounds on their behalf. And finally, what about the need to post to your Google Plus stream? This is more of wishful thinking on my part, but in reality, you shouldn't be coding in the ability to do HTTP requests to each one of the entities in your game. Although, you should definitely check out this place. I hear it's cool.